Kickspot insists that there should be a deliberate effort by stakeholders and financing aligned towards the move to attain a holistic energy transition for all citizens. According to Julius Mukunda, the executive director at CSBUG, statistics indicate that 90% of Ugandans still rely on rudimentary means of cooking like biogas, while 66% of them are energy poor. This even makes the transition debate wider open. Mukunda was speaking recently at a stakeholder meeting on energy transition organized by Rust Energy Consult Limited, a privately owned energy and environment consult company held at Silver Springs Hotel in Bogolobi.
You've heard that the biggest majority of Ugandans, 90%, we are still using charcoal and biomass. Dry wood and dry grass, and that's where we are. It will take you 12 hours if you are using charcoal to cook beans. And as such, is that for us to get away from that, we call it that energy, to clean energy, is what we are trying to discuss today. And that's what we call energy transition. Transition from dirty energy source to clean energy. But it is also coming at a time when we are expecting oil, and oil is dirty energy.
He highlighted that transition debate needs a careful analysis, adding that it is not wise to say we as a country should not drill oil, since this is a surer way to acquire much needed financing for the green energy.
We are here today for a workshop, energy transition in the eyes of a Ugandan. In this workshop, we have sub-themes that include the energy, Uganda's energy transition plan in addressing energy poverty. We are also analyzing energy policies in Uganda, and we're also looking at financing models to help address energy poverty, and we shall also go ahead to look at research opportunities in the area of energy in Uganda.
What is energy transition? Of course, it's moving away from what they call dirty fuels, mainly the biomass. It is extremely exciting to see that our students, the latest cohort, so they are our babies in the PhD program, have come up with such an ingenious idea to form a consultancy in energy. I know the talk today is on transition, but the consultancy itself will be beyond transition, generally in energy, because it has engineers, it has accountants, and other areas. But calling us today to talk about energy transition shows that they have realized, as students of the economy of energy, they are realizing where we need to be putting our focus.
Machari Robert Jackson, the chairperson of the firm, who is also a PhD candidate in energy economics and governance at Makerere University Business School, says the meeting was titled Energy Transition in the Eyes of Ugandans, with the aim of understanding how to incorporate the common person in the switch to safer and cleaner energy. It is critical for the debate to analyze energy policies, financing models, and how swiftly to address energy poverty problems in the country.